I have a lot of unfinished business with the Olympics.
She didn't want to give up. She doesn't give up. Paula Radcliffe doesn't quit races.
This is not the way she would want it to end.
Her Olympic dream is absolutely shattered.
For me, really, the worst that can happen is not being able to finish it and being in as bad a situation as I was in Athens. I came through that. So now this is about just going out there. I'm healthy going into it, and in a way, I'd maybe rather go into the race fully healthy and a little bit underprepared than in the shape I was in 2004, but just not healthy and not well enough to even really be doing the race.
You've always had that mental strength. I mean, you've done some superhuman things in the past. Is this the best of all as far as you're concerned? Because when you were diagnosed with a stress fracture, I mean, that could have been the end of it. Now you're here, you're heading into the games when most, you know, normal human beings perhaps would have given up a long time ago.
I think that certainly, gives me a mental lift to have got this far, because I think, I mean, honestly, if you'd probably told me right at the beginning of this, the bleakest medical diagnosis, which kind of came out in little dribs and drabs as I was going through the process, I think if I'd been given all that at the beginning, even I might have said, oh, you know what? I don't know, this isn't going to happen. And if I'm honest, there have been times in the last sort of 12 weeks where I've just thought, how can this be happening? Somebody's put a jinx on me, this isn't going to work out. But this is the Olympic Games, you give it everything that you can and you don't give up. And there have been times as well when Gary said, you know, somebody is just testing you just to see how much you want it, and you've just got to show how much you want it. The Olympics is something that little bit more special anyway, because it's something that you just dream about. When I was a tiny little girl, you're not dreaming then about a world championships, gold medal, you're dreaming about the Olympics, because it just is the pinnacle for us. I don't want to sit there watching the race wondering what could have happened, what could I have done. I'd rather just get in there and give it my best shot.
The Olympics always throws up amazing stories, magical stories, and I mean, do you dare even think that you could be the one here in Beijing?
I hope so. But like I say, I'm just going to keep focused on the race. I know, in a way, I went through the whole life's not fair and bad things happen just when you don't want them to happen 4 years ago. So I know that can happen. But the most important thing is it's sport, and it's you getting there and you give it your absolute best shot, and that's all you can do. And ideally, I'd be saying, yeah, I could do with another 3, really 5 weeks training. But I'm going to get in there and just give it everything that I've got. I'll be the freshest on the start line for sure. And I think I'll probably be one of the happiest to be there, because there have been those points when I really didn't think I would make it. And I think that can give you another lift and another boost on the day, hopefully too.